one?
Verdaj pomoj, oranĝoj, mandarino, ruĝa pomo, verda pomo, grapfrukto.
It's not like Klingon or something like one of these ones that you see on TV for a movie or something.
Ananaso, fragoj, flor de brasiko.
It's a language that's actually spoken in real life by real people.
Cepo for onions.
Uno, du?
Uno sufficias.
And I'd say it's the simplest language to learn. Anyone can learn.
Saluton, mia nomo estas Richardo.
Sal, mi nomiĝas Kaja.
Kutimiki, mi havas mian alian uniciklon, mi estas iom pli alta.
Just hearing upshots, you'd be forgiven for thinking this was a Spanish or German conversation. But if you listen closely, you'll realize it's neither, or kind of both.
I actually stumbled across it when I was surfing Wikipedia. I found an article about international languages, and I'm like, this sounds interesting.
Richard and Kiah are part of a group of just a few hundred Australians who speak a made-up language called Esperanto. It's the 1870s, and a linguist named Ludwig Zamenhof is living in Bialystok in what is now Poland.
He found, like, in the village where he grew up, there's four different language groups. You got Russian, Polish, Yiddish, and I think it was German. And they all stuck to their language groups, and they never talked to each other, and they always fought, and they was always fighting. And he figured, okay, we'll create a language where everyone could talk.
Zamenhof hoped Esperanto would not only bring the village together, but the world.
Basically, Zamenhof wanted to create a universal second language to bring about world peace. It's ambitious. A language that didn't necessarily come from anywhere, but that could be spoken by anyone. So naturally, it had to be quite easy to learn.
Uno, du, tri, kvar, kvin, ses, sep, ok, nau, dek.
If that sounded familiar, it's because it was supposed to. Esperanto is a mix of French, English, Spanish, German, and Slavic languages. It's phonetic and has much fewer words than other languages.
In English, you have a word for house, and then you have a word for cottage, and then you have a word for mansion. So three different concepts, but what is that? It's just a house in different sizes, okay? But you have to learn three words, three separate words. In Esperanto, you learn one word, domo, which means house, and you learn small, which is eto, and you put those together, dometo, which is a small house, which is a cottage.
Esperanto is considered one of the most successful constructed languages ever. It's estimated there are anywhere between 10,000 to 2 million Esperanto speakers around the world, the majority in Europe. There are also thousands of books, songs, and films produced in the language. And yes, that is William Shatner.
Resto tiuci. Mi pete.
So why don't people know about it? Well, Esperanto is not really needed. The world is far more interconnected now than it was 100 years ago, but the quasi-lingua franca is more or less English.
Like, I'll have people come up to me and they'll go, oh, okay, so you speak Esperanto, so what's that? And I'll say, it's a created language, designed to be a second language for everyone. And then 50% of the people will go, well, that sounds pointless. Why would you learn that? But you don't actually know anything about the language, how can you question?
The zeal and idealism that accompanied the creation of Esperanto has somewhat faded. A century and two world wars later, world peace is as elusive as ever.
Sometimes I think it's a little bit too starry-eyed, but I like to think there's still a bit of hope in me that someday it might happen.
Hope in humanity still.
But I'm not too fussed about it, I'm just having fun and talking to people.
Nowadays, Esperanto is taught and spoken primarily online, creating a very niche network of people.
I like the social cohesion of the Esperanto community, and I think it's changed my perspective on things in a lot of ways that learning perhaps a bigger language might not have. For instance, Esperanto speakers really love languages.
There's a word for colleague in Esperanto, which is colego. But if you took it apart like a normal Esperanto word, it means someone with a fat neck. That does not translate. Well, I've just made
it. It helps that all his colleagues have fat neck.
SBS estas.
Sendube le plej bona reto en la tuto de Australia televido.
Kaj la mondo, kaj la universo.
Yeah.